Good evening and welcome to the Grant High School Junior School Presentation Night. My name is David Thompson and I have the privilege of being a community leader here at Grant High School. I'd like to welcome our distinguished guests, staff, parents and of course the stars of tonight are the students who I hope can hear me out the back there. We're here to acknowledge the outstanding achievement of our young students in academic excellence. We seem surrounded by crises on all sides at the moment, which reminds me of the curse, may you live in interesting times. Our young students have people screaming at them in all caps about the existential threats that require some sort of reduction or some sort of escalation or a lockdown or maybe even more lockups. But always with the refrain that someone should be doing something. Well, tonight we celebrate the fact that someone is doing something. Up on the stage tonight, we'll meet our future leaders, our problem solvers, the creative people who demonstrate that they are up to the challenges that we as parents, teachers and the community have set for them. Thank you, and I would like to welcome the principal of Grant High School, Fleur Rochock, to the stage.
Matu Mankain, good evening. We acknowledge and respect the Boandik people whose ancestral lands we are meeting upon today. We also pay our respects to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people from other areas of Australia, and we honour their connection to country and culture. We honour and respect our community members and elders past, present and future, and are grateful for the opportunity to celebrate the efforts of our students in this beautiful place. Kaliai Didu, many thanks. 2023 has been about resilience. We returned to school mourning the loss of one of our students over the holiday break, while those young people most directly affected by this had to remain at home due to the COVID-affected staggered start. A teacher shortage combined with the COVID-19 pandemic made putting teachers in front of classes very difficult, particularly in semester one. And in addition to that, we are completely at capacity, so finding enough classrooms has also been a challenge. We've had some lessons in some very odd spots. Year sevens entering secondary school while undergoing that staggered start was likewise challenging, and to be honest, the demeanour and language of some of our new students was not at all what we were used to and took us somewhat by surprise. However, in true Grant High School fashion, we have persevered, and everything was a lot better in semester two. Although student behaviour-wise, we're probably still not where we finished last year. As a result, next year will see us working with our school community to develop a school-wide positive behaviour approach to building conditions for learning. Excuse me. We are proud of our ability to see a problem and work towards a solution with optimism and commitment. On that note, as we have reached the end of a third COVID-affected year, we acknowledge that everyone is sad about those things we've been unable to do over the past few years, and Grant High School staff are no different. We are happy to receive feedback, but please continue to be kind in the way you write to, speak to, and about us in emails and on social media and indeed on the telephone. It's been challenging for all of us, I know. We have seen significant progress in the implementation of our site improvement plan, with Caroline Wakefield leading this process with forensic planning and detail. It has been a joy to observe our educators developing their skills in teaching reading and comprehension during some of our student-free days, while other of those days have been devoted to work on lesson structure and pedagogy. On the sporting field, we have seen particular success in football and basketball this year, winning state titles in Divisions 2 and 3 of these competitions respectively. Unfortunately, and I seem to be doing a bit of yin and yang the whole way through this speech, due to the continued lack of temporary relief teachers will mean that we must confine ourselves to local knockout competitions next year, with the exception of Adelaide Athletics. And we thank the school community for their understanding of these constraints, acknowledging that other schools will also be facing the same problem and probably reaching a similar decision. We are delighted that four new demountable classrooms will be in situ for the start of semester two next year, easing our capacity issues. They will be located where the beautiful bike shed currently is. We're very excited about that going away. and this will significantly improve the streetscape of our school. We continue to lobby for a new gym and are hopeful that meaningful work on this development will commence next year. We're saying farewell to three long-standing staff members this year: Colleen Burney, our lab manager, who has moved on to a similar position at Mount Gambier High School; Jason Yates, mathematics coordinator, who is transferring to Brighton Secondary School; and Phil Walters, mathematics and science teacher, who is retiring. We thank these three for their excellent service to our school. I have now reached the end of my 30th year as an educator, and I'm feeling every bit of it. And I've decided that it is time I had a break to refresh and rejuvenate for the latter stages of my career. So I will be taking long service leave for semester one next year and for the remainder of this year after tonight. Caroline Wakefield will be principal while I am absent, and I wish her every success in this very rewarding role. Finally, I would like to thank our staff this year. We welcomed 30 new people to Grant High School, and we have finished the year with only a few leaving us and knowing that we have recruited wonderfully well in a very competitive environment. As ever, I wish you all the blessings of the holiday season, and I look forward to seeing everyone a bit later this evening, but also next July. Student leadership at Grant High School is on the up and up. Amazing things are happening. So it gives me great pleasure to welcome to the stage now this year's school captains, Megan Ruwalt and Molly Wild, and next year's school captains, Lily DeLayland and Lachlan Johnston.
Good evening, students, friends, family and staff. It has been an honour for Megan and I to represent Grant High School as the school captains this year, along with our incredible vice-captains, Chelsea and Brianna. We could not have accomplished anywhere near as much without you two. This year was the first fully functioning year of SLED, our new student voice structure created by last year's captains, Rachel and Caitlin. Over the year, our team has worked hard to give all students at Grant High School a voice in decisions that affect them directly, by running focus groups and surveys for every proposal we pitched. We worked on many proposals and policies this year, but have narrowed down some of our favourites. To begin with, we worked with our vice captains for our first project to decide how the PIB line for Year 10's second semester should be used. We ran two rounds of focus groups and two surveys to determine what students felt would benefit them during this time. And the majority of the students revealed that they wanted to learn more about finance or improving their personal well-being. We propose that this could be done by replacing the second semester of PIP with additional Kunga lessons to cover these areas. Our proposal for this project was implemented in semester two.
Due to the current climate crisis, we decided to begin implementing small strategies to do our part in becoming more sustainable. Our first course of action was the canteen, where we attempted to minimise as much unnecessary waste as possible and make substitutions for greener packaging. The schoolyard should soon be provided with recycling bins to encourage recycling and a cleaner environment. Many smaller projects also remain in the works, such as a clothing swap to assist families, whilst also minimising the amount of textile waste. Our major focus of the year was creating a solution to the lack of sense of belonging in the school. We found that students lack school pride and spirit, which contributes to poor behaviour and attendance. A solution we found was to abolish the sporting house teams and move solely to our communities. Whilst we realise this change is not traditional and will set us apart from other schools, it will allow us to hold more community events and give students a chance to become familiar with one group of students rather than two. Given home groups are separated into communities already, these lesson times could be used to organise events such as athletics carnivals rather than holding large meetings across the school. We have worked on fine-tuning our proposal and seeking feedback from staff and students over the second semester, and will be handing this project to next year's captains to hopefully reach a solution that students, families and staff are content with.
Authentic student voice was another issue that we tackled this year. We found that students weren't always comfortable sharing their true opinions regarding our projects, so we decided to look for new ways of communications that they were more comfortable with. We decided to create an Instagram account for the school where we could ask feedback online and polls could be launched. This account is joined with the Grant High School's Facebook page to deliver news and updates for school events. We also created a student and staff suggestion boxes on Daymap where students can share their feedback or ideas with us year round and even opt in to help implement their ideas.
In a moment, we are going to introduce next year's captains, but first we'd like to wish them the best for 2023. They have already started brainstorming ideas and we have no doubt that they will implement change at Grant High School that will benefit students. Congratulations to the school captains of 2023, Lily and Lachlan, along with their vice captains, Mia and Riley.
Thank you, Megan and Molly. Good evening, my name is Lily and this is Lockie and we will be your 2023 school captains. We are honoured to have been selected for this responsibility at Grant High School and we are grateful to be a part of this wonderful and diverse school community. At Grant High, there is a highlighted importance of student wellbeing, student voice and commitment to a dynamic, inclusive learning environment. Throughout 2023, parents and students can have a sound knowledge that as captains, we will continue to uphold the school's important morals and values of respect, trust and commitment. It is with great pride that we step into the roles of captains as we seek to further increase the interrelations and correspondence between the student body and leadership. As a result, we hope to see the student connectivity at Grant High School thrive in the year of 2023. With an already overarching idea in 2022 of increasing students' sense of belonging at Grant High School, we as captains are making it our goal to continue advocating for this. We are excited to continue the great work of the student-led development team that is already underway this year. It is with great pleasure that we recognise the roles of our 2023 vice-captains, Riley Seidel and Mia Kleinig, both of which were diligently involved in SLED this year. As captains, we intend to continue, improve and expand upon the rigorous work both Riley, Mia and the 2022 captains, Molly and Megan, started this year.
The 2023 SLED team has already outlined an ambitious set of goals for the coming year, some of which have started to come to fruition. For example, the concerns of the senior school students were relayed to SLED regarding the student car park and the inconvenience and safety issue of the faded parking lines. SLED presented this issue to staff, and were able to organise the repainting of the car park in the upcoming school holidays ready for the start of the new school year. We are putting a focus on student input and involvement in 2023. By being more active members of the school community and increasing our presence as captains, we intend to hear the student body more and to take their feedback seriously. SLED aims to do this by increasing the ways for students to communicate their ideas and feedback to us. Additionally, we want to continue the work of the captains in 2022 to create a stronger voice for younger students. As seniors, we believe that it is important for our junior school students to have as much input in decision-making as the older students. One main way we are planning on increasing younger student voices is through the development of the Future Leaders Program created in 2022 by the SLED team. We also aim at increasing greater school and community involvement and connectivity through providing students with increased opportunities to be involved in the planning and organising of school events. Furthermore, a new concept conceived by us as captains is to increase inter-school collaboration by working with the other secondary school captains in Mount Gambier as a way of gaining beneficial ideas for the improvement of Grant High School. Finally, a primary focus for the 2023 school year, which holds great importance to us as captains but also as students, is the advocacy for the awareness of mental health. We hope to increase positive school and student relationships in order to strengthen student wellbeing, inclusivity and understanding at the school. Once again, we are extremely grateful for the opportunity to be Grant School Captains in 2023 and look forward to working closely with the internal and external school community in a valid format to further improve Grant High School in the coming year.
Thank you very much for the ex-school captains and the incoming school captains. All right, we're going to start with the awards. First up, we have the Academic Excellence Awards for Year 7. That's being presented by Mrs. Jackie Pamarco. For Arts, Mathematics and Science, we have Matilda Clark. For Art, Riley Miller. Cultural Studies, Samantha Foster. Cultural Studies, Samuel Haas. For English, Emily Aylesbury. For English, Health and Positive Minds and Haas, Blake Seidel. For Haas and Health and Positive Minds, we have Xavier Clark. For Health and Physical Education, Elise Allen. For Health and Physical Education, Lily Cradolfa. Mathematics in Abstention, Joey Joyce. And for Science, Michaela Fleming. Congratulations to the Year 7s.
Academic Excellence Awards for Year 8 will be presented by Ms. Marion Hodson. In Cultural Studies, Lily McIntosh. In Cultural Studies, Chloe Day. Design and Technology, Will Merchant. Design and Technology, Lachlan Brearley. In English and Science, Claire Hopgood. In English and Science, Benjamin Harfel. In Haas and Health and Physical Education, Shaden Russell. In Haas, Jazz Cowling. In Health and Physical Education, Rhys Barrett. In Mathematics, Liberty Dowdle. In Mathematics, Zoe Pettingill. In Performing Arts, Levi Ramsey. In Performing Arts, in Absentia, Seth Spencer. In Visual Arts, Jackie Casley. In Visual Arts, Daria Lee Garland. Congratulations, Year 8s.
Presenting the Academic Excellence Awards for Year 9s will be Mrs. Caroline Wakefield. For Art and Craft, we have Imogen McGregor. Design and Technology and Haas, Carla Burns. Design and Technology, Lachlan Mitchell. Drawing and Painting, Lacey Jack. Drawing and Painting, English and Musical, Isabel Jones. Design and Design and Technology Textiles, Parker Overland, in Absentia. Food, Hospitality and Music, Summer Naismith. In Absentia, English, Health Studies, Mathematics, Media Arts, Science and Foundations to Modern History, Mia Cottle. Foundations to Legal Studies, Miller Prowse. For Haas, Bain Latin. In Absentia for Health Studies, Trinity Gear. For HPE, Mathematics Plus Stage 1 Personal Sports Development, Rowan Hardcastle. For HPE, Shayla Cole. For music, Allegra Hotham. For music, science and Year 10 drama, Zoe Norman. Photography, Sarah England. For recreation, Jace Maxwell. And for recreation, Noah Maxwell. Congratulations to the Year 9s.
The Marlene Lingham Memorial Performing Arts Development Award will be presented by Mrs. Caroline Wakefield and is presented to Matthew Cross. Our first introduction to Matt was seeing his audition for a role in the Grant High School musical she wrote this year. He was a driven and committed member of the musical cast, and took the initiative to practice his various roles and dances outside of rehearsal time and mentored the Year 7 and 8 cast members by teaching them their dances. We are very excited to see where Matthew performs next. Congratulations, Matthew.
The next awards are the most outstanding students in Years 7 and 9. This award is sponsored by the Lions Club of Mount Gambier and will be presented by Mr. Stephen Bell, President of the Lions Club of Mount Gambier. The awards for outstanding achievements at Year 7s and to 9 are presented to students who achieve the highest grades across all subject areas. Many of the students will receive straight A's in the subjects they have undertaken this year. Year 7, Alice Mitchell. Year 7, Blake Seidel. Year 8, Mia Forrest. Year 8, Ben Harfel. Year 9, Isabel Jones. And in absentia for Year 9, Mia Cottle. Well done. Thank you very much. That concludes the awards for Grant High School Junior Schools. Thank you very much.